This is tutorial 3rd of Cadence. In this tutorial, I'll be showing how to use symbols of other schematics in our new designs. So, as you know, in previous tutorial, we created the symbol of inverter. So, in this tutorial, I'll be using this that symbol of inverter in my new cell view schematic. So, let's give it a inverter one name, new schematic. So this is the work. Again, I'll go here instance. Now instead of using NMOS or PMOS, I'll go to browse. Instead of going to this, since I had to use symbol of my own from my own library, so I'll tutorials inverter symbol is here. Okay, and okay. So I'll create pins now. Can use R to rotate those pins, and similarly again I'll press P and out. Here I'll change the direction. I'll put it here. So once these are done, so I'll just do connections. Check and save. Now I'll give names, label, in and out. I can increase the font of them by changing the value here. In, this is out. And do again check and save. Now I'll go for launch, ADL. Now here I can create new state by giving again those values here, input, output, or the state which I have earlier saved for that inverter. I'll go for there, cell view, tutorial, inverter. This state I have saved earlier in that last schematic. So I'll just load that one only and I'll run it. So this is how we use. For example, now if I have to design the ring oscillator is like simplest is odd number of inverters, like I need 3, 5, 7 inverter. So I can just replicate this particular symbol here by cascading them and I can get particular ring oscillator. The design of ring oscillator will be discussed in coming tutorials. So for now, so this is the simulation results of this inverter. As can be seen, I use inverter symbol here and I'm giving these pins. Now one more, now we'll go to use of calculator. Now there are different multiple number of functions in calculator. So for loading calculator, there are multiple ways. So first of all, this one is like calculator. Okay, so I'm loading it here. So this is a calculator. Now here these are for this is for voltage, for checking the voltage. This is for checking the current, like for transient analysis, frequency, descent. This is for operating points, some variables. This is for RF applications, RF design. So here different functions are there. By clicking here, this function will come. Click on all. It will show all the functions of calculator, which are used to calculate different parameters. So this was one way of loading the calculator. Another way is like, I'll go to this schematic. I want to see outputs. Setup. And this, I'll go to open. It will open the calculator. That is one way. And second way. Another way is from this window. Here, I'll go to tools, calculator. So, there are the three number of ways to launch the calculator. Now how to use the calculator? So first of all, if I want to see the VTC of this curve. Okay, the VSP. So what I will do, if I want to check the slope of this curve, so what I will do, I'll click on this particular curve, I'll right click, I'll send it to calculator here. So when this is here, so what I will do, I'll click on function here, I'll write derivative. So it is coming here, derivative. So I am seeing the derivative of that particular curve, so that I will see the slope, I know the slope of that waveform. So once this is done, now if there is a, that the output of this expression is some wave, so I had to click on this one to display the wave. Otherwise, if it is some numerical value, so I had to click on this one. Since the slope will be some numerical value, so I will click on this one. Okay, sorry, it's it will be a curve, so I'll be clicking on this one. Now as can be seen, this is a derivative of this particular curve. I'll just right click on this one and I'll move it to next window to see it properly. So this is a derivative of my VTC curve. It will show me the point where the input and output curves are meeting each other. So this is here 684. This is 684. Yeah. Now what can you, if to define to show this value, you put just one marker here. This marker is here and you will give it like, okay, I want it 684. Okay, I chose X, yeah, I chose Y. 34. I have to take this. So this is the 684 value. I can just press M or also marker M and I'll just drag it here and here. So this is the 684. Now if I go to back to my this one and if I see this value here, this is the same 684. Let's put it. I'll just zoom it by bringing these two close. Or right click and drag this one. So it will show. Or what I will do, instead of doing this, I'll just create one marker here. So this is approximately 684 here. So this is one thing. Now if I want to see the delay here, in this case, what is the rise time, fall time, TPHL, TP, LH from low to high, high to low. So for that, one way is I will just again send it to calculator. Okay. So here I will write delay. So I have chosen output here signal 2. I'll choose input. I'll send this one to also calculator. Or else you can just click off and wave. It will show that, like if I click off and wave and I will go to my browser, it will, if I'm clicking on this one, it will be displayed in calculator. Like here. Okay. So I am clearing this threshold voltage, I am giving half of power supply, and let's see at edge number 2 what is the TPLH. This is okay, I will just okay, and since it will be some numerical value, so I will just click on this one. So this much of delay I am getting, 1.15 nanoseconds. So this is in case of transient analysis. Since we know in time domain we need to know what is arise time, fall time, slew rate, or we have to plot I diagram. So slew rate I will show in coming circuit. So for now, rise time, fall time, delay, we can also, if you want to see rise time of this one, I'll again send it to calculator. Or what I will do here, I'll just load calculator. I'll have one function here, rise time. Okay, so I have to see select signal, I have to select. So what I'll do, I'll use off wave. Let's choose this one. This is output. Okay. So output is chosen here. So initial value I have to give here, like 0, from 0 to 90%, how much it wants. Let's give it here 1.8. So 0 to 1.8 it is going, and 0 to 10 to 90% we are seeing. Okay, and again I'll see this. So this is the rise time for my output. Similarly, I can see fall time. So this is for transient analysis. Now what if I am doing AC analysis? I'll just close it, this one, and I'll close this one also. So for the purpose of showing the use of calculator for AC analysis, I have designed one single stage amplifier. For now I am just showing it, later on I will discuss how to design single common source amplifier, single stage amplifier. So this is the basic common source amplifier. So I'll just ground is 0. VDD I'll give 1.8. I'm giving DC and yes, I'll give 0.6, and some AC magnitude I'll give 1 micro. Okay, for now that will be. If I have to define frequency also, then I have to take sine wave here. So but for now I'm taking just it to see the AC analysis. Later on we'll do that also. So first of all, I'll choose DC analysis, apply AC. Now I'll do sweep. This is a single sweep. Actually, this is single sweep. But if I have to do multiple numbers, that is parametric analysis, which I will discuss later also. 10 to, I am varying my frequency from 10 to 10 GHz. This is automatic here. I can choose a linear or logarithm. By default, we take logarithm because it's too much. Okay. And say DC analysis. Here the operating point is okay. So now I have to see the gain of this amplifier, particular amplifier. What I will do here, output setup, open. Here I will, since I am doing AC analysis, so first of all I will go off. This is AC analysis for frequency, voltage, I have to see output voltage by input voltage, that is the gain. Okay, so VF, I'll choose this one. This is output. Again, I'll go off. Then again, VF input. Once this is done, you have selected your output and input. Click this divide, and it will be VOUT VM. Now we have to go for dB 20. First of all, make it all again. So this is again. Now see, once I completed this expression, I can go here, tool, send buffer to ADL or XL outputs, or what I'll do is this one is open from where I open my calculator. I'll press here get expression, it will show me this expression, and I'll get gain, I'll get name. So this is it. Again, what I'll do, let's start from again starting. Now for phase, again off, output frequency is net, then again off, output input, and then I'll press this one divide. Now I have to go for phase. So this is phase. Let me send through this way now. So it will come here automatically, you can see it, but the thing is that name won't be here. So what I'll just click on it, I'll give it phase. Okay, so this is it. I'm closing the calculator. Now once I define my outputs, I'll run it. So as can be seen from this figure, using calculator I defined my output expressions and they are plotted here. So these are two, but I'll split them. So this is my gain plot and this is phase plot. As can be seen, this is 20 dB around approx. This is phase one. Now what if I want to see the bandwidth? How much is my bandwidth? What I'll do, I'll just click on this, I'll send it to calculator, right click, calculator. Okay, so this is gain. Now function, I'll go bandwidth. Okay, it will be 3 dB low. Okay, so this is the bandwidth of my single say or common source amplifier, 38 megahertz. Okay, so this was about the use of calculator and the symbol. I tried to show you the basic functions that are used at initial status, but later on while you go ahead, we have to see like phase margin, gain margin, and third order spectrum analysis, we have to do FFT, different types of functions we have to use for our output displays. So we'll be using those by time. And one more thing is there, if I want to see the how much power it is consuming. Now first of all, I'll go again to that edit. Component display parameter, tell here, and I'll just click on this one. Window will come here. I'll see the region. Now, in cadence, region 0 is cutoff, region 1 is linear, region 2 is saturation, that is active region for MOSFETs, and region 3 is subthreshold. So, this has to be kept in mind. And this is in second region current of the Smith. Now I want to see the power consumption, so here I can just tell by looking at this how much power it is consuming, but for complex circuits how to see it. So what for that we have to go outputs, we have to go to save as and save all, okay, and then I just run it once again. So for now, I want to see how much power it is consuming. In this particular, I'll go here, browser. What I'll do, I'll just close it. I'll go here, tools, result browser. So this display window will come. Here, DC op, I'll just click on this. And it's showing me here how much power it is consuming. So it is around 24 milliwatts. Okay. So this is how we see how much power our circuit is consuming. Now one more thing is, this was by using calculator I was plotting gain and phase. Now instead of using calculator I can also plot this. Like what I will do, I'll go here tools, sorry results. Direct plot, here it is, AC gain and phase, okay. So I'll just click on AC gain and phase, and now after clicking on that I click on out and then in, it will automatically show me the phase and gain out. So this was for tutorial third. I hope you liked it, and now next I'll go for inverter layout. Once that layout is done, we'll see DRC and different LVS errors, how they are dealt with.